Hey, morning, guys. Morning, guys. Well, school started again. Well, not school, but work for us started again. So, feels good coming back to work on these buses. So, let me show you guys. I just arrived, so let me go ahead and start my day real quick. Like I said, guys, there's our fleet. And there's our shop. So, feels good starting work again. So let me go ahead and see what's up and get started, I guess.
Well, let's go ahead and pick up where we left off, and let's see how much work we can get done. We're gonna be working, I believe it's 2 days out of the week, Tuesdays and Thursdays. So, it's a start. So let me go ahead and get started on this one.
Well, this is where I had left off. Before all this Corona COVID-19, so let me go ahead and continue putting this engine back together. This is a Max Force DT, and I had already gotten the head torque down and the injectors are on, so let me go ahead and continue with the fuel oil rail, exhaust manifold, so on and so forth. I'm gonna go ahead and replace that little crankcase breather down right there. I'm gonna go ahead and replace that oil cooler and so on and so forth, guys. I'm just gonna go ahead and try and get as much of this one done. We got, I believe it. Let's go ahead and start by removing this little engine breather. When these go out, these are the ones that get all that oil. Oil goes into your turbo tubing and it goes into your CAC and causes a lot of damage. So we're gonna go ahead and replace this one. Let me get that crankcase breather out of the way. I mean, you gotta go under the bus. It's a little tight in space, but let me go ahead and get it done. We remove the crankcase breather. All we got to do is transfer this hose over to this new one. It's already got the couplings already bolted on there, so just this hose has to be transferred over, and we can go ahead and install this new one. The gasket's already in place, so we can go ahead and get that done. So guys, here on this one, keep the original clamp on that hose. We decided to remove this little 45 degree little coupling. We're gonna go ahead and remove this one. And we're just gonna go ahead and swap it over, and that's just because we want to keep this original clamp on there. We swapped out that hose, so let me go ahead and get it on. Well, guys, let's go ahead and start by getting that high-pressure oil well on those injectors so that they're no longer open and exposed. Let me go ahead and get that bolted on, and then we'll go ahead and continue, guys. And in this one, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Held down by 12 10 millimeter bolts. So let me go ahead and get this on. Well guys, high pressure oil well is done, so let me go ahead and get that valve cover gasket on so I can get that cover on there and keep everything nice and covered and not exposed to the trash or whatever's flying around. So let me go ahead and get that valve cover in place. And these are pretty simple. You basically just lay it on there. It's got little snaps that fold onto the oil well. And then of course you got all your injector connectors and of course the ICP way back here. So let me go ahead and get that one on. Well guys, that's the valve cover already installed. So let me see, let me get something else cleaned up so I can go ahead and continue with this one. All right, brought back guys. Well guys, let's go ahead and get this exhaust manifold on so we can go ahead and, we gotta get this one on first before we put the EGR cooler. So let me go ahead and start with this one. Well guys, I had to make a couple of changes on those bolts. I forgot about the heat shield, so I had to move around in order to get those heat shields back in place. I mean, this one covers that EGR cooler right there. And then there's another one up front. So let me go ahead and find those bolts, get those tightened, and get this bolted on. All right. Well guys, that's going to be it for now. It was a short day today. They wanted us to come in from 7 to 11. It's already 11, so we're going to be picking up our stuff and closing up shop. So I really couldn't do much to this one. But I am going to be back on Thursday, so 2 days from now. I'll go ahead and continue on this and see what else we can do to this one. And well, hopefully school resumes, or here at the shop, hopefully our hours resume to 40-50 hours so that I can continue getting these things built up, recorded, and put up on YouTube for you guys. So, well guys, appreciate you guys watching. Like and subscribe.